south of Denver is a really cool festival that they have each summer called the Renaissance Festival. And so I thought I'd support a little bit of it with the flowers here. And it is in July and August each year, and it is free to park. It's about $25 to get in per ticket, and you probably will be spending a lot of money here. But as well, we're seeing as each weekend they have a different theme. This weekend is Celtic, but regardless, you'll see people dressed up each weekend for it. I came out to my car real quick just to grab some food, as I didn't want to pay some of the bigger prices they have for food and wait in the long lines. But I did want to just kind of give you a little bit extra information while I'm out here. And one is that you can come and go as you wish. What you do is, once you're inside and you're coming back out, is they will give you a stamp, which is kind of hard to see. It's there on my wrist, it's blue. And basically this will allow you to go back in for the same day. So if you want to go somewhere and grab some food or come back to your car for any reason, you are able to do that, which is really nice. Another thing is that the parking is free and it is out in a field. So kind of keep that in mind, that if you have a smaller car, things like that, do keep that in mind for parking. But they have people that are showing you where to park, and if there's a ditch or something like that that they don't want you to park into, they will stop you and make sure that, you know, everything is safe for where you're parking. In addition to that, plan for about another 30 or 40 minutes on top of your trip once you get off of I-25. And that's just because of the traffic to get into the parking lot. Everything is well marked. It's just, there's a lot of people that want to visit. And so it does take some time to get through that line after you get off the interstate. So just plan for that. And then lastly, I just wanted to say that there are maps right when you get inside the festival, and do go ahead and use one of those and look around right when you get there so that you can orient yourself as to what all is there. Cause it is actually a lot bigger than you realize. And what they have on the right side versus the left side is very different. And it's a little bit easy to kind of get lost in there. Things do look similar, but they do have different shows, such as music shows. Acrobatics.
Down you go! Ah! Now. Ooh. Ooh, people like this one. Bring you around, put my feet right down the stairs, go to your feet, pop it up. Like that.
Juggling.
Here we are, 10 clubs, single spins, very quick, very difficult.
Everything's great, now keep juggling.
And jousting, as well as many other things that you'll want to make sure and plan accordingly. And then you can walk around in between those times, which is really nice. So I just kind of wanted to give you a little bit extra information, and I'm actually going to head back in there and show you some more.
Oh. addition to the show, such as the one behind me here, this is where the jousting was. All of the shows are family friendly, but this area that's actually behind me over here is just for children. This is a petting zoo, and this is really cute as they have different kinds of animals, such as pigs, alpaca, cows, rabbits, and other ones that you can pet and feed and stuff like that. So it's really, really cute for the children. But they also have big jumping trampolines where they're harnessed in and they can do little tricks and stuff like that. And so it's really great because those are a little bit more specified to children. Where a lot of people don't dress up, there are many people that do, as you might see some in the background here. And it's really fun. Not always is it specified to that weekend. This weekend is Celtic weekend, but people kind of just dress in whatever they have that's a little bit Renaissance or older. And so it's just really fun to walk around and see all of the different costumes that are here. I'm heading out now, but I just wanted to say that if you're able to come down here, it's definitely worth the money. For only $25, you get to see a real joust, and you get to have music and lots of food options, and you can really just take your time with this. There was one thing that I wanted to show you, but I wasn't able to, and that is that they have just the giant turkey legs, but unfortunately they were out, so I wasn't able to show that. But that's typically very stereotypical to have here at the Renaissance Festival. But anyway, I'm gonna head on out, and I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.